So in the first application, we determined the position of the halogen. In the next case, we are looking at what will you call this compound? It's a decalone, okay. Decahydronaphthalene decalone. So trans 1-decalone. What is the difference? These are going to be mirror images of each other. When R is hydrogen, this will be the decalone. Okay. All right. Now we halogen it, brominate. When we brominate, we see bathochromic shift in UV. Therefore, bromine is axial. Once again, bromine can be here or here. We show by chemical means that bromine is at the 2 position, not at the 9 position. In decalone, numbering will be like this. So UV showed that the bromine is axial. IR showed no change. This also tells us bromine is axial. Your initial was parent compound was positive cotton after bromination, strong positive cotton. We know the position, as I said, chemically we know that bromine went to 2 position. Today it would be very easy to know this. You will see this hydrogen now in NMR very clearly. We'll show coupling with the neighboring 2 hydrogens. Okay. So chemically and by NMR we know that halogen went in trans-decalone, there is no question of conformation. Conformation is fixed. Both rings have to be in shear form. And we know the sign of the cotton. So what we want to know is absolute configuration. So I write this, assuming that this is it, that would be the bromine. And now, next job is fix the absolute configuration. First, second, third describes anti-clockwise direction, hydrogen is below, this is your That's your S compound. Okay. We are not drawing this. We have shown only one just now. Okay. Now, what is the next job? Take the ketone to the head of the chair. When I take the ketone to the head of the chair, where should I put the bromine? That's the question that is in front of us. Ketone has gone to the head of the chair. Should I light the bromine here? Should I light the bromine here? Light the bromine. Anywhere, light it. First, light it. Then, see what happens. Okay. So, check it out. First is bromine. Sorry. I drew the chair in the wrong place. Okay. So, bromine is first. Ketone is, direction is clockwise, hydrogen is above, therefore it is S. So I have drawn it in the correct manner. Bromine is on the right hand side, therefore axial haloketone rule says that Cotton effect should be positive. Okay. All right. That's your ketone. That's the hydrogen above, transferring junction. Okay. That's the bromine. That's the hydrogen. Now, ketone has come to the head of the chair. What do we see? Bromine is on the right hand side. Okay. Now, let's confirm this result by using octant rule. Okay. Let's put the numbers. Miss, you are going to help me. That's your carbon number 1. Where is your carbon number 9? Left hand side. There. Carbon number 9. Carbon number 10, carbon number 4, carbon number 3, carbon number 2. Okay. How is the 9-8 bond? The 9-8 bond is equatorial. How is the 10-5 bond? The 10-5 bond is equatorial. Okay. So, that's your 10-5 bond, 9-8 bond. 5-6 is again equatorial. 9-8-7. Okay. If this was hydrogen, what would we see? Positive cotton. Only these will contribute positive. If it's bromine, these will contribute positive. That will also contribute positive. So you will see strong positive quad. Okay, let's all right. What do I want you to see in this? Where should I put it? Okay. What am I trying to tell you? This are almost on the plane B. Can you see that? So this and this are almost on the plane B. Models have also become very old like me. All right. Okay. And what is going to contribute? 5 is going to contribute positive, 6 is going to contribute positive. So without bromine, weak positive, with bromine, strong positive. Therefore, your deck alone has this absolute configuration. Okay. Let's look at our next example. Plus 3 methyl cyclohexanone. We showed in the last time's lecture that this is the R absolute configuration. We are chlorinating this. And we are chemically showing that chlorine has gone to 6th position. Absolute configuration is fixed because plus 3 methyl cyclohexanone has been shown to have all absolute configuration. Position is fixed, it has gone to position 6. That's your next picture. After you put it at position 6, the name will change automatically because then you will call it 2-chloro-5-methyl, but that's only nomenclature. All right. So we've gone to position 6. In isooctane solution, UV shows bathochromic shift, IR shows no change. Okay. It shows strong negative carbon. Our starting material, weak positive carbon. Okay. Now there is one question for us. The chlorine at 5 position, at 6 position, sorry, is it cis in relation to methyl or is it trans in relation to methyl? Okay. If it is cis in relation to methyl, then chlorine is on the right hand side, we should have got positive carbon. Therefore, it is not cis. Cis chlorination should have given us positive one. IR tells us it's axial, okay? UV tells us it's axial, IR tells us it's not equatorial. And cotton effect also, large change tells us it's axial. Therefore, if it's not cis, it must be trans. If it's trans, then what's the problem? The chlorine is not axial if I write this conformation. So the problem is to determine the conformation. If I ring flip this, that would be the picture. And when I take this ketone to the head of the chair, whatever is on the lower surface will go to the upper surface. Up will become down. Down will become up. Chlorine has now gone to the left hand side, therefore, negative carbon is effect. Is anything troubling you at this stage? We are writing a chair and saying both substituents prefer axial geometry rather than equatorial geometry. This is one bad thing for us. Let's check whether what will happen with this. Okay. So methyl is below, chlorine is here, ring flip. You ring flip, you get this ketone down, chlorine on the upper surface, methyl on the back surface, turn it round. Chlorine has now gone on the back surface and downwards, methyl is on the front surface and upwards. Make the octane projection, that's going to be the octane projection. ketone is here. I'll just call this 3-methyl to make it easy. Ketone is here, carbon number 5 is here, chlorine is here. Methyl is on the right hand side and axial, chlorine is on the left hand side and axial going downwards. Well, if we are writing equatorial, remember we are putting the group horizontal. When it's axial, we have put the group vertical. Okay. All right. So why does this isooctane solution prefer to have both equations? If I do this, what is the problem? Number one, they are eclipsed. Number two, there is dipole-dipole repulsion. When I make it axial, I remove that dipole-dipole repulsion. In a cyclohexane, chlorine axial, chlorine equatorial is more stable than chlorine axial by only 0.4 kilocalories. In a cyclohexanone, chlorine equatorial is unstable as compared to chlorine axial because of dipole-dipole repulsion. So what is the answer? The dipole-dipole repulsion contributes unfavorable energy greater than having the methyl in the axial position. Therefore, in isooctane solution, it shows this. This same compound, if I look in methanol solution, it gives me weak positive cotton. What does that tell us? In methanol solution, this is the conformation. In isooctane solution, that is the conformation. How does that happen? When I have methanol, the chlorine negative charge is dispersed and therefore dipole-dipole repulsion is much less. So in isooctane, dipole-dipole repulsion is very large. In alcohol, the charge on oxygen, charge on chlorine is dissipated and therefore the preferred conformation as both substituents equatorial. So that's a very nice example to show in two different solvents, conformations are different. And this can be very nicely demonstrated by looking at octane rule. Okay.
In the methanol solution, the chlorine won't be replaced.
No. If it was replaced, the problem would have been very different.
So why is it so much?
Huh?
Why isn't that getting replaced?
When you want to replace it, what will you do? Would you like to make it SN1? What would you like to do? SN1 is impossible because you are creating positive charge next to a positive carbon. So only you can do it when SN2. If I warm it, if I heat it, yes, I can do it. But this I am only putting a solution. Okay. All right. All right. Two alpha metal, five alpha, telling you ring junction is trans. Go less than 3. Okay. We are doing bromination and we are looking at the product of kinetically controlled bromination. All right. Bromination has gone to 3 position. Today I can demonstrate this very easily. What will happen to this methyl? In NMR, this methyl will be singlet. If bromine goes here, I am sorry, this methyl will be doublet. And after bromination, if bromine goes to 2 position, there is no hydrogen, therefore methyl will now be singlet. Okay. So UV shows bathochromic shift, IR shows no change. Initial compound positive carbon. So when we look at this, what's the picture? We introduce the bromine at this position. All right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So that's expected to be the product. Use rule of thumb. What will happen? Whatever is on upper surface will come to lower surface. So bromine has come on the right hand side. So it should have been positive carbon. But the observed was negative one. Three, two, one, four, five. The hydrogen which was below has gone up. The methyl which was up has come below. That's your carbon number 3, carbon number 4 is here, carbon number 5 is there, 2, 1, join it, that's your carbon number 10. Okay. How is the 5-6 bond? 5-6 bond is equatorial. How is the bond between 10 and 9? The bond between 10 and 9 is equatorial. At this point, equatorial goes up, axial comes down. So the methyl is coming towards plane B. And carbon number 9 is going upwards, 9, 8, 7. So parent compound would be positive. And bromine compound should be strong positive. So both axial haloketone rule and octant rule tells us that it should have been positive. At this stage, there are two answers you can give. One is, in this compound, octant rule, axial haloketone rule has failed. Or the structure which we have given is wrong. So, they prepared this compound by a different method. And they showed you strong positive carbon. So, axial haloketone rule has not failed. Octant rule has not failed. So, something is in the structure is a problem. The only problem that you can do, we know bromine has gone here. Therefore, can you see something? It has very large methyl-methyl interaction. It also has very large bromine carbonyl eclipsing interaction. So, what does it do? How much is the chair bolt difference in a cyclohexanone? It's only 2.7 kilocalories. Methyl-methyl is already very large interaction. Carbonyl-bromine eclipsing interaction is also very large interaction. And therefore, compound goes over into boat form. And when it goes over into boat form, now the bromine is axial in the boat form. So that problem which we had, UV shows biothochromic shift, there you see the negative carbon. So this is an example of a compound that exists in boat okay. Can you see that? Ketone, bromine, that's what we wrote first. All right, bromine axial. When we wrote this, then we took this ketone to the head of the chair. What do we see immediately? Bromine is on the right hand side in the octane projection, positive contribution. This very large positive, so strong positive is expected. Okay. So then, can you see this? Oxygen bromine eclipsing. Tremendous problem here. Can you see that? Can you see? Methyls have become far apart. Bromine has now become axial in the boat form. Make the octane projection. What do we see? This is upper left, negative. This is lower left, negative, strong negative Courtney effect. What does this example tell us? Axial haloketone rule, octane rule also applies to boat form. All right? Okay. That's your ketone. Your carbon number 2 is on the left-hand side. That's your bromine. That's your carbon number 1. That's your carbon number 10. That's your carbon number 5. Carbon number 4. Methyl group is axial, going downwards. 10-9 bond is equatorial. 5-6 bond is equatorial. 8-7. When we started, we said, when I do halogenation, halogenation normally goes axial. Why does it go axial? Carbon-hydrogen bond and carbonyl pi clouds are parallel to each other. So why in this case it is not going as we want? Can you see what is the reason? When it wants to go axial, there is an interaction between methyl and bromine. So small percentage of starting material exists in boat form. And now, as expected, if the carbon hydrogen bond has to be parallel to the pi clouds, bromine will come from below. The top face attack is blocked because of the methyl. Therefore, small amount of chair form becomes boat. Reaction takes place, boat becomes brominated. So, again, small amount of chair form becomes boat. So, bromination is taking place in the boat form. In the starting material, chair is preferred over boat. In the product, boat is preferred over chair. That's how, that's a very classic example of this case. Okay. So we looked at the axial haloketone rule. In our first example, we used it to predict position. In the next example, we used it to predict the absolute configuration. And the next two examples, we showed the conformation. In the first example, we showed that in isooctane, we have conformation in which both chlorine and methyl are axial. And in alcohol solvent, we have a conformation in both are equatorial. Then in the last example, we showed that we have a compound in which the preferred conformation is a boat conformation. Okay. Now we are going to use octant rule for trans decalones. All. That's trans 1-dichalone. And we are specifying the absolute configuration at carbon number 9. One is first, carbon number 10 is second, it is third, describes anti-clockwise direction, hydrogen is in front. Therefore, this is the R absolute configuration. 9R trans 1-dichalone. Next job, convert planar structure into chair structure. Check it whether there is any mistake. Direction is anti-clockwise, hydrogen is front, that's 9R. Now take ketone to the head of the chair. Okay. I hope you saw that when I light steroid, this carbon becomes number 5, but when I light decalone, that carbon becomes number 5. Okay? Ring junctions have the last two numbers. In steroid is different. Okay. Okay. So we have written carbon number 1. Where should I light carbon number 9? That's the question that you have to ask yourself. Should I put 9 here or should I put 9 here? This is the question. One answer is write it anywhere and see what is happening. Okay. So that's your 9. Okay. So oxygen 9-8. Oxygen 10-8, sorry. Describes anti-clockwise direction. Hydrogen is below. Therefore, it is S. Therefore, that's not all right. That you can see is the R absolute configuration. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Where is going to be your carbon number 2? Left. 2 is left, 9 is here. So that's your carbon number 3. That's your carbon number 4. That's your carbon number 10. Okay. So now the questions are, of course, where should I write carbon number 5? Yes, please. How is that bond? 10-5 bond, equatorial. Equatorial means it should be horizontal. 10-5 bond. Okay, how is the 9-8 bond? 9-8 bond is equatorial. 6-7. What's going to be the sign of the cotton effect? All substituents are in upper right, therefore negative cotton. That's okay. What happened? Okay. All right. So that was our first structure. Then make it into this structure. Then bring the ketone to the head of the chain. Sorry. Ketone to the head of the chain. All right, that's your keto. Carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4. All carbons are to the right. And what are the other things you should see? All these atoms, 1, 9, 8, 7, are all lying close to the plane B. That's your first example. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Both ring junctions in the first example were hydrogens. Now, some problem? Okay. Here, this is a hydrogen, that's a methyl. So that's your 10 methyl trans 1 decalo. Specify the conformation here. Carbon number 9 is first. Between 4 and 5, this ring has a ketone, that ring doesn't have ketone. Clockwise direction. Methyl is in front. Therefore, S 10 methyl trans 1 decalo. converted planar structure into chair structure. Check it out. Clockwise, metal is above, that's S. That's your next structure. Check it out whether that's the correct structure. First, second, third. Clockwise, metal is above, that's S. Where will I write carbon number 2? Left hand side. That's your carbon number 9. 2, 3, 4. Okay. Then, how is the 9-8 bond? The 9-8 bond is equatorial. How is the 10-5 bond? The 10-5 bond is equatorial. What will be the sign of the cotton effect? It will be negative, but what's the difference? Here hydrogen is contributing negative, here methyl is contributing negative. Therefore, that will be more negative. Both will be negative, but this will be more negative. Okay. Okay. That's your planar structure made into chair structure, ketone taken to the head of the chair. Only these two carbons, carbon number 2 and 3, are on the left hand side. Everything else is on the right hand side. And this methyl group is contributing negative. Therefore, this compound is more negative than that. Amplitude is equal to minus 20. Okay. This is a derivative of an acetyl product called as arimophilone. Okay. So we convert this into that structure. Just like we converted this into this, only difference is we have put that metal group there. That extra metal I put. Okay. What do you see? What do you expect? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have an isopropyl here. If we have an isopropyl here, what will happen? Isopropyl is going to make positive contribution. Therefore, expected will be less negative than that. It may be slightly positive, but it will be less negative than that. But answer is, it is much more negative. Amplitude is equal to minus 109. What's the picture? When I do this, now what? Isopropyl and metal have tremendous 1,3 interactions with each other. Therefore, this becomes a boat. When it becomes a boat, that interaction is relieved. Please remember, in a cyclohexane, chair boat difference is 5.5 kilocalories. In a cyclohexanone, it's only 2.7. So if interaction is more than 2.7, you can't make this. This thing is fixed. So you flip this, you get into this. And when I get into this, what's the picture that I see? That's going to be your picture. What has happened to this carbon? This carbon has gone into lower octant, and that is in the upper octant. Now what has happened? This which was positive has become negative, and isopropyl which was positive has also become negative. Amplitude has become minus 109. So it's another example where optical rotatory dispersion has said that this compound exists in boat form. Why does it go into boat form? Methyl axial isopropyl axial interaction is more than 2.7 kilocalories. Therefore, automatically ring goes over into boat form. Yeah. What will you call this compound? Yes, please. Where is the ketone? Two position. So it's 10-methyl trans 2-decalo. Then we are specifying absolute configuration. First, second, third. What is the direction? Direction is clockwise. How is the methyl group? Up. Therefore, it is S. Direction is clockwise, metal is up, therefore it's S. Miss, come to the board, take the ketone to the head of the chair. Put the numbers which will help you. Apply rule of thumb. Whatever is on lower surface will go on upper surface. Whatever is upper surface will come on lower surface. Nine, ten, not five. That was all right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nine. After four is joined to 10. Okay. Nine is joined to 8. Methyl group. Okay, check it out whether it's all right. Okay, so that's S. All right. Methyl group. S, all right. That's S ever required. Now make the octant. How is the 9-8 bond? Equitable. No, don't rot. 9-8 bond is equitable. How is the 10-5 bond? Equitable. Where will you draw equitable? Upwards, yes. Very good. So what's the result? Positive carbon. What you have to understand is, do each step very systematically. Okay? When you make the change, write the numbers properly, don't be in a hurry. She has done a very nice quick job. Okay? All right. So expected is positive carbon. The point that she has written here is also important. What is that important? At this point, axial one comes downward, equatorial one goes upwards. What will you call this? Systematic name? Yes? Nine metal trans dodecalo. That's not enough. We must specify what is the absolute configuration. So at 9, 10 is first, 1 is second, 8 is third. This describes clockwise direction. Methyl is up. Therefore, that says. I just draw this little differently. So I have the ketone at the head of the chair. Draw the octane projection. How is the 9-8 bond? Equatorial. How is the 10-5 bond? Six and seven are to be drawn. 5 is joined to 6, 6 is joined to 7, 7 is joined to 8. Draw the methyl group, please. What is the sign of the cotton effect? Compare this one with this one. Which will be more positive? More positive. Why? Methyl group is also contributing positive. Okay. Okay. All. Where we are left. Okay. Let's put it. So this compound is similar to Coal-S10-2O. Okay. We didn't show it, so let's show this. That's your planar structure. Going to your chair structure. What she did very nicely, took the ketone to the head of the chair, got this structure. Then made the octant. Everything is on the left. Only these two carbons, carbon number 3 and 4, are on the right. I hope everybody is seeing this. The methyl group is almost coming on the plane B. All right. That was the picture for the first compound. Okay. That was your next compound. Planar structure made into chair. Chair already has the ketone at the head of the chair. Once again, only these two carbons are on the right, carbon number 3 and 4. Everything else is on the left. And as clearly seen, this metal is contributing positive. So, that's the picture. All right. This compound is like Coal-S10-2O. When I look at Coal-S10-2O, it is amplitude A is equal to plus 121. And this has an amplitude A is equal to 121. I'm not getting the right number. A is equal to 56 + 121. Now we are using another very nice we have taken the ketone, dissolved it in methanol, taken the Awardee spectrum. Now into this, you add a drop of HCl. What is expected? First you will get this, and then this will lose the proton. So ketone hemiketal equilibrium will be there. When I add HCl into this, your amplitude from plus 56, it goes to plus 17. After adding HCl, amplitude is plus 17. What does this tell you? Initial compound was 100% ketone. After adding HCl, what is this? It has reduced almost by 30%. It's now only 30%. Therefore, ketone percentage is only 30%, ketal percentage is 70%. 56 has become 17. What is the ketone? What is the cotton effect due to? Cotton effect occurs in the region where compound absorbs UV light. So, moment you make that ketone into hemiketal, it does not absorb UV light in that region. Why does ketone absorb UV light at 300? Yes? It is the N2 pi star. Okay. So, once I remove that ketone, oh, after HCl, 70% hemiketal, ketone. When I look at colas 10-2-1, add HCl, the ketone percentage amplitude is now 121 has become plus 109. Very small reduction in amplitude. What does it mean? Very small percentage is hemiketal. So, question is why? What do I see here? In the hemiketal, for the two ketone, there is steric interaction between metal and hydroxyl. In this case, when I make hemiketal, there is interaction between OH and hydrogen. So, in the 3 ketone, both compounds have positive cotton. 2 ketone has more positive because metal makes positive contribution. Add HCl, in 2 ketone, it remains mainly ketone, 90% is ketone, only 10% hemiketal. Why? Because hemiketal is more hindered, therefore, ketone is favored. The 3 ketone hemiketal formation is easy. And therefore, we see this picture. Okay. What we have shown, we have used axial haloketone rule and also used octant rule to explain the results of axial haloketone. And then we showed how in the case of transdecalones, we can draw octant projections, we can predict the sign of the cotton effect. When we meet tomorrow, we are going to look at the cis decalones. Cis decalones are a more difficult story than the trans decalones. Why? Number one, drawing chair structures for cis decalones is more difficult than drawing for trans decalones. Number two, in cis decalones, there are two conformations. In transdecalone, there is only one conformation. So there are two possible chair conformations in cisdecalone. Therefore, to do the job with cisdecalones is the next stage which we are going to see. So tomorrow we are going to meet, same time, and hopefully by 12 o'clock we will be through. I hope you have also seen that if you really want to understand stereochemistry in all its facets, you must make models. Okay? Don't see the models only in the class. Try and make them. We have lots of models in our department, so there's no excuse for not seeing them. If I was an agent, I will tell you, if you want to do cyclohexane stereochemistry, use that model, okay? That's a very nice model for you, cyclohexane. It used to cost $1 per carbon. So when we bought it, fortunately, it was 10 rupees a dollar. Today, it's 66 rupees a dollar, okay?